lying in a comfy bed for hours, watching the latest hit series, playing games, and maybe even going to virtual reality. Nah, I'm not describing a perfect lazy day. I'm talking about how you'll probably fly on a plane of the future. A long flight may take over 10 or even 15 hours, and all this time, all you do is try to position your legs so they don't become as stiff as tree trunks, and anticipating a jet lag while trying not to go insane from boredom. About time someone should do something about it. Good news! Airlines are on it right now. We're used to planes having several separated sections, like a cargo hold and a passenger cabin, but that may become an old tale one day. New concepts propose all the sections to be completely modular. They can be moved around and adjusted to the situation in a matter of hours. It even comes to the idea of passengers staying in a cargo hold for the whole flight. Don't worry, it doesn't mean you'll be strapped to the container with your luggage. Instead, you'll be comfortably sleeping in a lie-flat berth placed in the cargo section, perfect for an overnight flight. Standing seats, on the other hand, are the opposite of comfortable. A lot of airlines will go any distance to reduce the cost of the tickets and squeeze in more passengers. Sardines, anyone? Standing seats are much lighter than any economy class ticket seats. They allow to fit a lot more people inside the cabin, and they're in no way suitable for a long-distance flight. You barely even sit on these things. Let's hope this concept doesn't become too popular. Back to the good stuff. You're lying down, there is a screen in front of you that shows the newest episode of your favorite TV show, and it is all controlled with your smartphone or tablet. Better yet, you're absolutely separated from other passengers. These so-called air lair individual cabins are placed on top of each other, which provide a lot more space to make use of. And interactive entertainment systems like these screens are already finding their way to airplane cabin holds. But they have some alternatives. Recent years have been all about VR technology. Surprisingly, it may help to feel less stress during a flight, since VR goggles can fool your brain to feel steadier and make you forget that you're more than 30,000 feet above the ground. Combine it with seats straight from a movie theater, and any flight may become a film marathon, just without popcorn. These seats are the perfect compromise. They're compact, lightweight, and comfortable. They fold when not occupied and adjust to the person sitting in them. Now, the perfect addition would be great sound, but headphones the airlines give to their passengers now leave much to be desired. Future flight seats will solve this problem with a built-in-to-seat sound system. It will cancel out the noise for other passengers, while you'll be enjoying high-quality sound with no uncomfortable headsets at all. And even low-cost flights will have things like that. Entertainment screens in the seat backs have already come. They have a great number of movies to watch, and some even allow you to choose and order food, as well as give information about the place you're going to. Your personal devices will also see much more application in future flights. While today, the connectivity may badly interfere with a plane's own systems, in the future, they will be much better protected. This means that the airlines will start to provide Wi-Fi on board more often in the next few years. Mostly though, your best call for entertainment is to look out the window and enjoy the view. Speaking of which, I still always envy pilots. They can see so much more. Luckily, in the future, we're going to have a whole observation deck on some planes. The fully transparent section on the plane top will provide a mesmerizing view on the cloudy fields around the plane. Engineers promise that this observation deck won't stand in the way of the plane's aerodynamics and won't get clouded by moisture. There are materials now that can go transparent and back in seconds at your wish, and these can be used in the making of the plane too. New concepts suggest that planes of the future will become even more like birds than today. They will be much more lightweight and still sturdier. The net of tube-like structures will replace a solid hull, and between them, you can put any lightweight material that will stand against the speed, clouds, and wind. Okay, maybe fully transparent hull is a bit too much, but screens can be not only entertaining, but quite useful too. One of the future airplane projects gets rid of the long cabin and transforms a plane into giant flying wings, making it look something like a stingray. There will be no windows at all, and passengers will sit in something that looks much more like a theater than a plane's cabin you're used to. Manufacturers doubted this idea for a while, until the screens came up. They will not only be able to live broadcast the image from the outside, but also adjust to, for example, play the sunrise earlier or later, as it will be at the destination point. It will help passengers to both sleep better and reduce the jet lag. Aircraft manufacturers look forward to changing the fuel option for good. New airplanes should do much less noise, leave no exhaust, and not waste many thousands of gallons per single flight. And with recent breakthroughs in battery development, it may finally be possible – electric airplanes. Of course, at first, these planes will be relatively small – something about 20 passengers at best – and they won't go too far. Just 300-mile flights are what engineers aim at right now. But this is just the beginning. Some projects focus only on small-sized aircraft, like flying electric taxis for 5 people. These unusual cabs will take off vertically and make the whole concept of traffic jams obsolete. Anyways, electric and hybrid jet engine developments are aimed at reducing carbon emissions in aviation by 25% in the next 5 years. New silent engines developed by Cambridge MIT. These planes won't be heard anywhere outside of the airport itself. And NASA is busy developing their N+3 project, an aircraft propulsion system with 60% fuel economy. Electric aviation is still a bit far-fetched, though. Electric airplanes prototypes will only go through test flights in upcoming years, and we won't see them anytime soon. Jet-propelled airplanes are still the talk of the day, yet they won't stay the same either. One day, we may see the plane bolting at 25 times the speed of sound. From California to Europe in just an hour. Easy peasy. It will blast off the ground like space shuttles used to do. Oh, speaking of speed, do you know why supersonic airplanes are so underused in commercial aviation? Sonic booms. When a plane goes beyond the speed of sound, it releases a sound blast like no thunderstorm can ever produce. If every flight would use supersonic airplanes, we would live in an unbearable world of extensive noise. Fortunately, it's just another challenge to overcome. The release of Supersonic Green Machine is scheduled for 2030. It will use innovative engines capable of reducing nitrogen-oxygen emissions by 75%. And its tail will have a boxed V-shape, which should allow to mask sonic booms. For a more convenient traveling experience that won't include going at the speed of sound or 2.5 Gs of force thrown on you, there will also be a no less futuristic-looking option. A flying V airplane concept splits the usual hull of the plane in two and places both of the resulting sides onto wings. Jet engines will be on top of the plane, which will make flights much quieter and comfier. This plane is designed for very long flights and with maximum energy economy in mind. It will use 20% less fuel during a flight and will have enough room for more than 300 passengers. Now, for all of the mentioned novelties, the only problem is a lack of investment. But hopefully, with time, at least some of the hot projects out there will have enough budget to launch, and we will fly in more comfortable, safe, ecological, and faster planes than ever before. Hey, Speedy! If you learned something new today, then give the video a like and share it with a friend. And here are some other cool videos I think you'll enjoy. Just click to the left or right, and remember, stay on the bright side of life.